There's no way. That was so f***ing cool.
Yo, what's good? So today we're going to be reacting to Billie Eilish. She just released two new songs off of an EP, I guess if you want to call it that, called Guitar Songs. And we're going to react to both of them right here, right now. So let's just jump into that. And by the way, I'm in the process of moving from the EU to the US. I don't know why. But so if you're wondering where the couch is, some incredibly large German man took it. I love the just, if this is just her voice and a guitar, that's fucking awesome.
I don't wanna talk right now. I just wanna watch TV. I'll stay in the pool and drown. So I don't have to watch you leave. I put on Survivor just to watch somebody suffer. Maybe I should get some sleep.
She has the most chilling sounding vibrato. And the coolest thing, at least to my ears, is that in some of these phrases, she's actually adjusting the speed of her vibrato. So on talk, it's a relatively fast. And then on now, it's a lot slower. So it's like a talk right now. Make sense? It gives it this like eerie, asymmetrical vibe. And also it helps push the song forward. But anyway, let's continue. Let's see if she does it again.
Sinking in the sofa while they all betray each other.
Yes.
What's the point of anything?
So this whole phrase, she's actually doing a type of vibrato that I've never heard from her before. So the typical vibrato is just an alteration in pitch, right? Pitch goes up and down. And what she's doing here is more so less of a vibrato and more so of a it's a bit more goat-like. I'm not going to say that. I've never heard her do that before. It's so creepy.
Are missing again.
Ooh.
That's what happens when you fall in love.
What?
You don't have the time. You leave them all behind.
That's sad.
You tell yourself it's fine, you're just in love.
We're only a minute into this, but this is some of her best songwriting. Hands down.
Don't know.
Oh my god, we did a whole album of this.
What about the plans we made?
It's so sad.
The internet's gone wild, watching movie stars on trial while they're overturning Roe v. Wade.
True.
No. That's what happens when you fall in love.
This is so haunting. It's so beautiful. Which, by the way, I heard that she wrote this touring in the EU while Roe v. Wade was being overturned in the US. Which makes me, it's kind of weird because I'm moving back. Don't know if I want to go back.
You leave them all behind and you tell yourself it's fine. You just.
That crack is so gorgeous. It fits so well.
Maybe I'm the problem. Maybe I'm the problem.
I love this because it's just so raw and so completely straight from her and out. She wrote it, she produced it in such a short period of time. Boom, it's out, which I think is really, really cool.
Maybe
it's super authentic. I think that's what makes it sound so authentic. It's probably her most authentic song. One of, at least.
Maybe
How did she record that? Oh, I love that. I've never heard something like this before. This is so cool. Oh! That was absolutely incredible, dude. That melted my brain. That completely melted my brain. All right, next, the 30th. Woo! Love the upbeat.
It's hard to believe you don't remember it. Woke up in the ambulance. You pieced it all together on the drive.
Oh my god, her falsetto is so fucking good, dude. Like, she has such like a beautiful like hold to it, right? And there's so much air on that as well. It's such a beautiful tone. That's something that she's so good at doing with her voice, is just creating such beautiful soundscapes and tones. She might not have the most range. She might not do all these crazy runs and things like that, but what she does do such a good job at is creating an image, is creating a sonic landscape. You like that word?
I know you don't remember calling me. But I told you even then you look so pretty in a hospital bed.
I'm gonna cry.
I remember you said you were scared, and so was I.
She loves doing these slides. You were scared, so was I. I feel like, not that she's not always had her own style, but I feel like she's progressively more and more and more as she experiments and branches out and then pulls things back, finding something super unique. Like, these two tracks to me are really freaking unique. Like, there's a lot of songs that I liked off of her last album, obviously, but this is more my style. Oh, and by the way, you can watch me reacting to her last album on my Patreon if you're interested. I would put it up on YouTube, but it got blocked, so I think it was a good stream.
And I stand still on the five. Thought it was unusually early traffic. Usually I don't.
So by the way, this song, I think
just wanted,
I read, is about her friend who got into a car accident. It's pretty sad.
When I saw the ambulances on the shoulder, I didn't even think of pulling over. I pieced it all together late that night.
She saw it?
Jeez. And I know you don't remember calling me.
Oh.
But I told you even then you look so pretty in a hospital bed. I remember you said you were scared, and so was I.
Oh.
What if it happened to you on a different day, on a bridge where there wasn't a rail in the way, or a neighborhood street where the little kids play, or the Angeles crest in the snow or the rain? What if you,
oh my god, this is about to go,
kids in the car? What if you were remote, no one knows where you are? If you changed anything, would you not have survived? You're alive, you're alive, you're alive.
There's no way. That was so fucking cool. Ooh.
I mean, obviously, it's a sad song, so it's sad. But everything that just happened there was... Ugh. I haven't had an eargasm like that in quite some time. It's everything at once. Like, it's the production. Absolutely amazing. It's the songwriting. And also, it's the subject of the songwriting, obviously. Everything coming together and climaxing in that way was fucking so fucking good. I don't know about you guys, but to me, this is the peak. This is her peak. I don't know what I was thinking, but I didn't expect these two songs to be so good. Because a lot of times when artists do these, like, oh, quick throwaway song, like, boom, they're usually just like, I can see why you kind of just threw this up there, because it's just okay. To me, this is some of her best work.
And I know you don't remember calling me. But I told you even then you looked so pretty.
Oof.
In your hospital bed, I remember you said
Her vocals are back to being very bright again, by the way. They took a little bit of a darker turn in terms of, like, her vocals got a bit fuller in her last album, at least in my opinion. They're back to being kind of bright and more, Sorry for cutting her off. Oh, I love the ending of that. You have the huge build and then just boom. Sound of her pick falling into the sound hole of her guitar? Maybe? I hate when that happens. But I told you even then you look so pretty. I don't remember her having so much hold sound on her voice, so much of this sound without the air. But I hear it here. This is the closest that I remember her doing this. I never reacted to this, by the way. Maybe I will one day. Let me guys know if you'd like me to react to her covering Bad by Michael Jackson. But anyway, I think this is a somewhat new thing for her as well, is adding these this like bit of a hold onto her voice without the air, and such an extreme amount of it too. And you look so pretty. But yeah, this was absolutely gorgeous. Both of these songs together, I think, are some of her best work. And I really want to hear more stuff like this. So cool. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you very, very soon. Until next time, Tristan.
And Tristan!
Peace. I don't think she likes it over there.